something about chronic prurigo, that there is a new definition and a new terminology, because there was a lot of confusion in literature about what prurigo is. There are a lot of different terms associated with prurigo, and the ADV Task Force Pruritus tried to come to a unifying terminology regarding chronic prurigo, and it met in 2 years ago when it defined chronic prurigo as a distinct disease that is characterized by chronic itch, that is itch that that occurs for 6 weeks or longer. It's also characterized by a prolonged scratching behavior and by the development of pruriginous lesions, which are can be plaques, nodules, even papules. They are hyperkeratotic, usually have a hyperpigmented border, and might be excoriated. And that's a clinical definition of chronic prurigo. And a very important aspect of it is that itch must be present before the lesions. So first comes the itch, and due to the prolonged scratching behavior, the chronic prurigo develops then. And that's important to differentiate from, for instance, psychogenic scratch lesions, in which there is no itch, but the clinical aspect might be similar. Research in recent years has brought new light to the pathophysiology of itch. We know that the nerves at peripheral and central level play an important role, and the sensitization, especially regarding C fibers that are not activated by histamine, so non-histaminergic C fibers. They seem to be sensitized in patients with chronic itch, regardless of the origin of the itch, if it's a dermatose or a neuropathic condition or a systemic condition. And some studies have also shown that at central level, there seems to be also a neuronal sensitization, and also that itch inhibitory mechanisms may be impaired in patients with chronic itch. About prurigo, there's also some new studies which try to find how the itch occurs in patients with prurigo nodularis, and some interleukins are of relevance. So the guidelines are for the treatment of chronic itch are complex, but the main message is that they recommend a stepwise approach. So, and in the first step, it should be done an effort to find the etiology of the itch, and at the same time, while doing the diagnostics, basic measures should be initiated, like antihistamines, if needed, topical steroids, also emollients, and other basic measures like avoidance of trigger factors. That's step one of the therapy. If that's not enough, so if the itch is not reduced at a satisfactory level, the guideline recommend a therapy that is aimed at the origin of the itch, so a so-called symptomatic etiological therapy, because we know that certain agents work best at some kinds of itch. For instance, gabapentinoids work good at neuropathic itch conditions, or for instance, opioid modulators work good for nephrogenic itch. So the guideline recommends that at the second step. And if this still doesn't work, or if the cause is unknown, the guideline recommends agents that that work on the so that inhibit the itch transmission, and these are often central acting agents, for instance, anticonvulsants, antidepressants, or also opioid modulators.